With more than 35 nations, 30,000 people, and a million components working together, we share one simple goal: to illuminate the way to new energy. The Principality of Monaco, just a two-hour drive from the ITER worksite, has committed since 2008 to fund the appointment of young scientists from around the world to perform their own postdoctoral research at ITER. Having recently earned their PhDs, each of the Monaco fellows bring invigorating insights to the ITER endeavor. And with just 1 month left before the next Monaco fellowship application is due, we need your help recruiting the next cohort to join us at the world's largest scientific collaboration here in the south of France.
On 12th of January 2010, His Serene Highness Albert de Monaco donated 5.5 million euros over the next 10 years to support five young scientists every 2 years.
I would like to congratulate each and every one of you of all nationalities who contribute to this exceptional scientific and human adventure. Thank you very much.
Originally, we had no way of attracting promising young scientists, and so we were very fortunate that the Prince of Monaco felt that this nice project in his backyard was worthy of investing in. Because of the wide range of applicants that we can have, it's very, very competitive. So whoever we end up getting is always a top quality person, pushing the goal of fusion for mankind forward. So this group is no exception.
Well, as you may know, in the core of the ITER machine, there is this very hot gas that is called the plasma. And the goal of the science division is to understand the behavior of this plasma. And for that, we do very large scale simulations. So me, I focus on a particular plasma instability, which means that the plasma moves. And in this case, the plasma moves vertically up to the wall. For doing this, we use supercomputers. So this simulation, for example, is one plasma of NSTX, which is a tokamak in the US. And we do this type of simulations with other machines because we need to predict what ITER will do in the future.
The inside of ITER is comprised of plasma-facing components. And the purpose of those components is to be able to absorb and conduct away all of the energy that's produced during fusion operations. Don't get me wrong, the first wall doesn't have to handle these extreme loads all by itself. ITER is going to have a disruption mitigation system that is capable of detecting these abnormal events early on before the plasma ever comes in contact with the wall. But as responsible engineers and physicists, we have to know exactly what the consequences are if the disruption mitigation system misses, say, 1% or less of these disruptions. Do you end up getting local melting on your surface? And is there any melt motion from all the forces going on inside the machine?
Plasma actually inevitably touches the surface, and among the surfaces, the so-called diverter. The plasma can directly strike the diverter structure, so sometimes it can melt diverter structure. So to make diverter structures to be sustainable, we need to cool down the boundary plasmas enough before it touches the diverter structures. So I'm doing the plasma simulation, which deals with the plasma as a fluid, and it requires a lot of computational powers. That's why I'm using supercomputer in ITER.
My work is related to the pellet injection in ITER plasma. Pellet is a hydrogen ice shown here. By injecting this pellet, high heat flux is mitigated. But the problem is the plasma transport after pellet injection is not yet clearly understood. This kind of particle simulation track the particle motion by solving the equations for each particle.
Here at ITER, I'm working on the diagnostics, basically, which are things which can measure plasma parameters, like the current, temperature, density, these kind of things. One of the ways is to use a camera, because we have like temperatures which are like still millions of degrees centigrade, so we can't directly put something into the plasma. So we have to use like light or laser. And the ultimate aim is that you use all these measurements to finally control the plasma. Also, but you know there is a plasma.
So we have people from material science, from engineering. They bring new perspectives, fresh ideas, and new motivation that also helps us to move forward.
I'm enjoying a lot this work because I'm in contact with the fusion community and meeting many experts, so I'm learning a lot. This is cutting-edge research.
It's been really nice moving here and starting work at ITER as a part of a group. Really, our group of Monaco fellows has done a fantastic job of just, you know, getting to know one another and finding things to do and hang out on the weekends outside of work.
It's great because normally in this kind of international environment, people tend as well to get with the people from their own countries and gather. And in our case, we succeeded. Sometimes we are very different. We have managed to be the friends, so come out always together to eggs, and we have a lot of fun.
I mean, I feel the ITER-Monaco postdoc is a very great opportunity for young researchers that you can contribute to, like, one of the most important projects going on right now in the field of fusion. And even if you are not that old or senior, but you still get an opportunity to work with people and give your small contribution to that project.
Hello.
Hi.
Oh, we should do our welcome thing again.
ようこそ. こんにちは.
Bonjour et bienvenue. Welcome to the ITER NOW, the end of the video. Thank you for watching. We're going to answer some of your questions now. So it's been really great getting some of your questions on YouTube and Instagram.
Yeah, I received so many questions from you, and this is so great. Thanks for participating.
Aditya says, it's great to hear about your outreach program. Thanks for liking ITER NOW. How can individuals apply to make an appointment or a visit to ITER? Great question. It's ITER.org/visiting.
Yep.
And you can just sign up right there and join a group or bring your own group. Mm-hmm. They take groups of 10 or more.
Yeah, and visits are free. So totally everyone free. Can join.
Mm-hmm. One more question from someone named Yuri. Is there a way for us commons to help you?
Well, definitely.
don't consider yourself commons. We're all common people here. We're right. all normal yeah. people. We're just doing something that mm-hmm. seems grand. But I mean, my favorite answer is just keep watching ITER NOW and share it, and be an ambassador for fusion and help yeah. people think this
right.
is cool.
And share our Instagram posts and Twitter, retweet Twitters, and yeah.
And come visit.
And come visit,
thank you for being a fan. Everybody, thank you for watching. Keep sending us more questions. We'll try to answer them as best we can from now on. Au revoir.
Sayonara.
See you next time on ITER NOW.
Bye.